former head of the Philippine Information and Communications Technology Department is concerned after lawmakers suggested to the government to use ABS-CBN's frequencies for distance learning in the coming school year. This report tells us why.
Motion is approved.
Just days after a House committee denied ABS-CBN's application for a new franchise, an administration congressman now wants the government to use its frequencies for distance learning during the pandemic. But it may not be practical and cheap, according to former Information and Communications Technology Secretary Rodolfo Salalima.
If they did it more costly on the part of the government, why? Because you need people to run that on a 24/7 basis.
Salalima doubts if the government will have enough people and the expertise to operate another broadcast network and its entire programming just for the proposed distance learning.
Ngayon, wala nang operation ng IBS as a broadcasting company. Sino ang mag-ooperate?
Of course, he says the government may tap former ABS-CBN employees to run the broadcast.
Pwede rin, but it is very costly now because you are going to keep alive the entire network. Samantalang kung nag-ooperate yan ng IBS, it is IBS paying for the operations of the network.
If the government didn't shut down the largest broadcast network in the Philippines, Salalima says it would have been easier to tap the network and purchase specific time slots for distance learning during the pandemic. With no franchise, ABS-CBN is expected to lose its broadcast frequencies. But Salalima says the law requires that this scarce resource be granted to the best qualified, meaning regulators will have to choose from among several applicants vying for frequencies. In the case of ABS-CBN, he acknowledges that it may not be easy to recover its old frequencies, even if it acquires a new franchise in the future, especially if the frequencies are now reassigned to a qualified company that can maximize its use. He says one option is to look for vacant frequencies or look for better ones, which are not being fully utilized. Attorney Rodolfo Salalima now joins us on the line this morning. He's the former chief of the Philippine Information and Communications Technology Department. Good morning, Secretary Salalima, and thank you very much for joining us again.
Magandang umaga, Christian.
Okay.
Magandang umaga rin sa bayang Pilipinas.
Okay, I'd like to start this interview with a bit of hope, however slim that might be. Let's talk about the options for ABS-CBN after the Congressional Committee on Legislative Franchises slammed the door on its bid for a new franchise. What are the options here? People are talking about a possible People's Initiative. What do you think of that?
Well, pwede rin yan because, in effect, the franchise is in the nature of a legislative enactment. So, in effect, a franchise is a law. The People's Initiative is a form of legislation where the people directly will make the law. And to my mind, I do not see any legal obstacle on People's Initiative legislating the franchise for ABS-CBN. Ang problema lang nga dito, yung mga logistics natin, the movement, all the actions to be taken, medyo matagal-tagal yan.
So basically, when you talk about the practicality of that option, do you see any problems, especially since we're 2 years away from the elections?
Medyo may inconvenience in the sense that, say, for example, we have to allocate a budget for all of this. The COMELEC has to be activated for this purpose. But if there is a will, they said, there is a way, and then it can be done. As to any legal obstacle, as I'm saying that it is only Congress which can't do the franchise legislation, I doubt that kind of reasoning. I still believe that the people can directly legislate the franchise of ABS-CBN via the People's Initiative.
But as far as the lower house is concerned, you think that it's actually game over? No more options available there?
Well, in which case we'll have a judicial controversy which may even again reach the Supreme Court. But I, on my own, I believe that the people can legislate directly because, in fact, the power of Congress to legislate is a direct delegation of the sovereign will of the sovereign people. And therefore, if the people can on their own do the legislation, therefore the people can also directly or delegate that power. So a power delegated can be exercised by the principal author.
Okay, but personally, what do you think of the denial of the application for a new franchise? Of course, when you talk to the lawmakers who voted in favor of that, they're saying
that... The question is a little complicated, Christian, because if you talk of a due process, in the case of Antibay versus CIR, this is a 1940 case, and repeated in the case of Globe versus NTC. NTC, this was... issued by the Supreme Court in the year 2003 or 2004, the Supreme Court had laid down the criteria for one to be accorded due process. While it can be said that the action of Congress is in the exercise of its legislative power in granting or in denying a franchise, nonetheless, in the hearing of that franchise, the nature of their legislative action partakes of a quasi-judicial nature. And there are pros and cons on this, but based on the criteria laid down by the Supreme Court in Antibay and versus CIR in regard substantive and procedural process, mukhang nagkulang.
Okay. What about the claim by others that this could be challenged as high as the Supreme Court because of the so-called grave abuse of discretion? Especially if you're going to, for example, invoke the Equal Protection Clause under the Constitution. Because the reasons cited against ABS-CBN were not also cited when other broadcast networks were applying.
From the viewpoint of reason, that is tenable. Ang problema nga lang natin, ultimately, the issuance of a franchise is the exclusive power of Congress. So rightly or wrongly, I do not think the Supreme Court can say and order the legislative body to issue a franchise because that power is legislative. And in a sense, the grant of that power is in the discretion of the lawmaking body.
Okay, so you just have to respect the results of the lower house at this point. Anyway, I'd like to talk about the frequencies of ABS-CBN now that the franchise application was denied. Now, how urgent is it for the NTC to reassign the frequencies of ABS-CBN?
Well, if the NTC sees that there is a need for the use of that frequency, given that Congress had refused to renew the franchise of ABS-CBN, then the NTC must now hear the ABS-CBN on the earlier Siokos order which the NTC issued to ABS-CBN in May 5 this year. Because remember when the NTC ordered the ABS-CBN to cease and desist from its operation, the NTC also accompanied that order with a Siokos order, not for ABS-CBN to explain why it should stop operation, but rather the Siokos order was for ABS-CBN to explain why the grant to it by the NTC of its frequencies should not be revoked. So that is now on the table. I hope that issue be now resolved.
But isn't that moot and academic since ABS-CBN's application for a new franchise was already denied?
Well, theoretically, it is moot and academic. But I said when you talk of due process, there is such a thing as substantive law. So it may be from the point of view of substantive law, there it is now moot and academic, but there is also procedural. That is why there is a Siokos order for still ABS-CBN to explain why. There may be a reason why it can hold on to that frequency, notwithstanding it's the fact that it had already lost its franchise. So, isinasabi natin na may kasalanan ka man, kailangan pakinggan ka pa rin for that body to finally make a decision.
Okay.
That is due process.
Okay.
Hindi lang on the merit of the case based on law, based on facts, but kailangan pakinggan ka. That is why there was the Siokos order.
Okay, but technically, with no more franchise, ABS-CBN can no longer hold onto those frequencies, right?
Mahihirapan.
Okay. Now, but how urgent is it for the NTC to reassign that?
Well, if there is in the public interest Because remember, Republic Act 7925. This took effect on in March 1995. And the law says in Section 4 that the assignment and the utilization of the frequency which is owned by the state must be in the public interest, and that its utilization shall be governed by international agreements or agreements local plus international convention, and that the award of this frequency, being a scarce public resource, must be given to the best qualified applicant who can make an effective and efficient use of this frequency to meet the demands of the people for telecommunications and broadcasting service.
Okay.
So if there is a need and there are applicants, then the NPC must therefore calibrate and decide which of the many applicants are best qualified.
Now,
so you go by the criteria on how to choose the best qualified.
Now, if there are no qualified applicants and there's no public urgency, assuming that that is the case, the government would still hold on to that, to those frequencies.
But the government will then, right? Hold on to the frequency, but it will not assign the frequency to any private individual because of the fact that there is no applicant best qualified to utilize this frequency in the interest of public service.
But can it reassign those frequencies in the meantime to a government broadcast station?
Pupwede. Mm-hmm. Because remember that in Article 12 of our Constitution, there is that Section 17 or 18. It says in there that frequencies or even private properties may be utilized by the government, and under Section 17, in case of national emergency, even private properties may be utilized only temporarily to meet the emergency, provided that if it is private property, the owner of that property be accorded due process, and the acquisition of that of the government of that private property must be on reasonable terms and subject to remuneration. But in this case, if you are simply talking the frequency, if the NPC revoked the grant, then the frequency reverts to the government.
Okay. But if you're going to allow the government to make use of those frequencies in the meantime, especially during the pandemic, the requirement under the law to assign a frequency to the best qualified does not necessarily apply in this case, right?
Hindi muna because of the national emergency.
Okay.
Yung pinag-uusapan kasi nating grant noon by NTC under the law is a grant which is more or less permanent for as long as the grantee utilizes it efficiently in the interest of public service. But in case of national emergency, pwedeng gamitin ng gobyerno.
Okay.
But the question there, Christian, here is, hindi mo naman magagamit ang frequency kung wala kayong transmitter, walang radio stations, walang network to use that frequency. So without a network using that frequency, utilizing that frequency, ang frequency mo is useless.
But can the government, let's say, take over the facilities and equipment of ABS-CBN?
Well, if that kind of move is within the contemplation of Section 17 and Section 18, yes, under the concept of national emergency. But under Section 17 of Article 12 of the Constitution, the use of the government is pansamantala lang. Because it is only meant to address the emergency. And if the network of ABS-CBN will be used so that the news frequency will be utilized in public, in the interest of the public,
but
then NPC must be heard, there must be an agreement on reasonable terms, and NPC, rather ABS-CBN, must be remunerated for the takeover.
But outside of that provision and section under the law, can the government take over the facilities and equipment of ABS-CBN? Let's say when you talk about the revocation of the existing frequencies. Because during the hearings, we heard some congressmen claiming that the reacquisition of the Lopez family of the equipment and facilities of ABS-CBN after the EDSA revolution was questionable, according to them, even if that went through the process up until the Supreme Court.
That is a legal issue which must be settled ultimately by the courts. Hindi na pwede doon mag-decide ang Congress because that is a question of private ownership. Hindi na yan franchise na where Congress has the exclusive power. That is why, because the ABS-CBN claims that it is the owner of the private hardware, the infrastructure, the network, and the radio stations, that property is a private property and the ABS-CBN cannot be deprived thereof pursuant to Article 3 of the Bill of Rights under Section 1 and under Section 9. Okay. Under Section 1, it speaks of the provision that no person shall be deprived of life, liberty, and property without due process of law. And under Section 9, where private property is taken by the government, mm-hmm. meaning ownership is transferred to the government, the private owner must be duly compensated.
Okay.
So yung mm-hmm. yung sabi-sabi natin na ito'y nakuha lang ng hindi naman pag-aari ng IBS, that is a legal issue. And the claim of ABS-CBN is to the contrary, that they were in fact the one who put up this infrastructure.
Mm-hmm. So just to be clear, let's say the government invokes the national situation now, the health emergency, as a reason or perhaps even an excuse to make use of the existing facilities and equipment of ABS-CBN, they can do that. But ABS-CBN is also protected under the law, because that should be temporary and there has to be compensation.
Under the Constitution,
yeah.
That the takeover must be based on reasonable terms, that there must be just compensation. And you relate that Section 17, Section 18 of Article 12 of the Constitution to the basic Bill of Rights, yung Section 1, due process. Because eventually, when they try to reach an agreement on what are the reasonable terms for the government to temporarily use the network, ay magkakaroon dyan ng judicial controversy.
Okay.
And at the same time also, the Bill of Rights provides that this being private property, the hardware, the ABS-CBN must be duly compensated for its use.
Okay, finally, Secretary Salalima, how do you determine if an applicant for a frequency is the best qualified among those applying?
Well,
or do you follow a certain standard?
Under Republic Act 7925, under Section 4, and under existing rules and policies of the NTC, an applicant may be granted a franchise for telecoms and broadcast operations if it is legally qualified. One, under the legal qualification rule, you must have a franchise from Congress. Number two, it must be technically qualified. May mga tao ka ba na pwedeng mag-operate yan from the technical viewpoint? And it must be financially qualified. Maliban diyan, sinasabi doon sa batas natin that the applicant who will be declared as the winner and assignee of the frequency must utilize the frequency in a manner efficient and effective mm-hmm. to meet public demands for telecommunications or broadcast services. So, kung gawin ng NTC ang matinong pamamaraan, ay dapat i-award ang frequency yan sa taong makakapag-optimize ng use niyan. Hindi po pwedeng ibibigay lang sa highest bidder. That is not the law. That is not the rule.
Okay, Attorney Rodolfo Salalima, thank you very much for joining us, sir.
Okay.